हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू मैथमेटिक्स क्लास. ऑलरेडी यू नो वी आर डिस्कसिंग यूर लास्ट लेसन एंड दैट इज डेसिमल्स एंड वी आर सॉल्विंग यूर इवेल्युएट पार्ट फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 166. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई हैव सॉल्वड फर्स्ट मीन राइट द डेसिमल फ्रैक्शंस फॉर द शेडेड रीजन. नेक्स्ट राइट द फॉलोइंग डेसिमल्स इन न्यूमरल्स. नेक्स्ट ईयर राइट द फॉलोइंग डेसिमल्स इन वर्ड्स. इन प्रीवियस वीडियोज वी डिस्कस्ड राइट एज अ डेसिमल नंबर. And next, write as a expanded form. Okay, so I hope you practiced that all the examples, dear students. They were very important examples, and the same topic is there for class for you also. So please keep practicing that all the examples. And most of the students are not sending homework. Please send your homework to my WhatsApp number. So without wasting time, we will start our today's class. Then what in today's class? In today's class, we are going to learn convert the following fractions into decimals. Dear students, see here we are learning to convert fractions to decimals. In previous videos also, I taught it as a briefly. For that, there is a trick, and if you once understand that trick, then you can write the fractions into decimals. So I will take some examples from your textbook, and that is 3 by 10. Next one is 2 by 100. Next one is 12 by 1000. 12 by 1000. 1 234 by 1000. And one more is there that I will solve later. 674 by 100. Okay, so let us solve this example already I taught. And once again I will remind you to make decimal places. We need here in denominator, we need the denominator as a 10, 100 or 1000 or 10,000. Okay, so here 3 by 10 is there. Already I told the trick. First you have to write the numerator. So here you write this 3 as it is. And in you see the denominator 10 is there. In denominator, how many zeros are there? See, in 10, how many zero is there? 1 0. So after one digit, you have to give here point and write here 0. First, you have to need to write the numerator as it is. Next, you see in denominator how many zeros are there. If 1 0, you give after one digit point. If 2 0, you give here point after two digit of the number. Next, here I will take here one more example. 2 by 100 is there. Then how to write? First step, we have to write this numerator 2 as it is. And here in denominator, see 100 is there. In 100, 2 zeros are there. How many zeros are there? 2 zeros. Then after two digit, I have to give the point. I have to give point. But here only one digit is there. So here you put one more zero. This two after two digit, you have to give here point and write here 0.02. So again, here what we have to do? First you write the numerator. 12 is there. So count how many digits are there. 1 2 3. After how many digit I have to give here point? 3 digit. 1 2, and this point, and give here 0. By mistake here 2 digit, 1 digit is there, means you need to give there that much of zeros, then only you give point here. Don't write like this. For example, 12 is there after 2.0 here. This is wrong. If here 4 zeros are there, means here you give 2 zeros. Here again 5 are there, means you give here 3 zeros. Okay, so here, so the answer is 0.012. So next count here, 1000 is there. Next here I have to convert this as a proper fraction to, not this is mixed fraction, I have to convert this as a improper fraction. Multiply this and add. 1000 1000 1000 plus 234 is 1234 by 1000. Okay, so right here 1 2 3 4. After how many digit the point will come? After 3 digit. Okay, 1 2 3. 1, 2, 3. Here you give the point. 1.234 will be the answer. I hope you are getting my point. Here I converted fractions to decimals. Okay. I will take one more example from your evaluate part only, and that is 674 by 100. Then how to solve this? 100 6 is 600. 600 plus 74. 674 by 100. Okay. Next you write the denominator as it is, 674 after two digit. You have to give here point. So the answer is 6.74. Got it? So next, move to next example. So take here, I converted fractions to decimals. Now we have to convert decimals into, and that is G1, convert the following decimals into fractions, and that is 3.2, 1.05, 0.06, 0.3, 5.35. So A, B, C, D and E. So this is also very easy. I will tell you one trick and you can solve these examples also. So for example, here 3.2 is there. Now you assume here just 32 is there, and write here 32, but here point is there, okay? Ignore that point and write here 32, and see, already you know this is, for example, here 425.56 is there. So this is whole part and this is decimal part. Whole part, decimal part. Dear student, just see here in decimal part how many digits are there. One digit is there. It means here you write 0 and give here 1. One digit, 1 0. 2 digit, 2 0. 3 digit, 3 0. Only you have to see the decimal part. Don't see this whole part. I hope you understood which one is whole part and which one is decimal part. So this is decimal part and this is whole part. Okay. So next here, ignore this point and write here 105. And see, here once, here in decimal part, how many zeros are there? 2 zeros. So write here 100. Okay. Next here you write 006, and in decimal place two digits are there, means you give here 2 zeros. Next here you write 3 is there. Okay. 03 or 3, both are same. If you are writing 03, that is also correct. 03 by 10. Dear student, 006, it means 6 by 100, and this also means 3 by 10. So here next one more example is there, and that is 5.35. So how to do this? I will solve this up. 5.35 is there. Ignore this point and write here 535, and ones and tens is there, so write here 100. So this type we are going to solve this all the examples. 535 by 100. Just you have to see this decimal part. In decimal part, 1 digit, 1 0, 2 digit, 2 0, 3 digit, 3 zeros. I hope you understood this. Here I will complete your first semester syllabus, and in next videos I will send videos regarding your periodic test to exams, and I will revise once again the multiplication, division, multiples and factors, and fractions, and this decimals decimals part once again. I hope you are getting my point. So solve this evalu part, solve neatly and send it to my WhatsApp number. I hope today's class is clear to you. Thank you.